So having roots in Detroit and growing up during the prime of Motown, also being a part of the hard bop tradition in Detroit, as I mentioned, she's always been transcendent of genres. For example, following her master's degree, she spent the better part of a year touring with the former Supreme, Mary Wilson. And over the course of her career, she delved into avant-garde, hard bop, free jazz, and even funk and electronic music. She was always guided by a broader vision of uniting different sounds of the African diaspora and reflecting on their porous boundaries and continuity. These are just some examples of different projects she did over her career that went to many different musical areas. Open on all sides in the middle was a large electric and acoustic ensemble featuring Steve Coleman and a tap dancer. Twilight in 1989 was with her and the band of Detroit musicians, and also they used African instruments as well as synthesizers in an album full of original compositions. A Child is Born in 2011 was a Christmas album where she played not just piano, but farfisa organ, celeste, clavinet, and Fender Rhodes. Her album, Grand River Crossings, was actually a solo piano album where she did her own versions of Motown songs. And significantly, she was also one of the first pianists since the 1950s to record with the free jazz pioneer Ornette Coleman, who usually found piano players to be too harmonically restrictive. At the same time, around the same time, she filled the piano chair in Betty Carter's quartet, the legendary vocalist and mentor. And this album was actually named after her original composition, Feed the Fire. So now I'd like to show you all a clip of her playing one of her own compositions entitled Dark Prince, which you'll get to hear my version of a little later. I would just like to point out that she always plays with a level of freedom and spontaneity, but it's always extremely sophisticated, and it's hard to kind of categorize her into one style of playing because she regularly visits so many different approaches to playing. In addition to her rare qualities as a player, she also had a significant impact in the field of jazz education, teaching at several schools and serving as director of jazz studies at the University of Pittsburgh and starting her own jazz intensive. These are just some of her academic achievements here. Mary Lou Williams is an unsung hero, a pianist, composer, and band leader who mentored many of the more known jazz musicians such as Charlie Parker, Miles Davis, Thelonious Monk, Dizzy Gillespie, Bud Powell. But I would just like to bring attention to Geri Allen is a big part of the reason that musicians today credit Mary Lou Williams for all her work. And she held the first ever Mary Lou Williams Cyber Symposium, where her, Vijay Iyer, and Jason Moran performed a three-piano improvisation from Columbia University, Harvard University, and the University of Pittsburgh in real time. She also collaborated to produce two musical theater projects. The first one called Great Apollo Women, which premiered at the Apollo Theater, and the second called A Conversation with Mary Lou, which premiered at the Harlem Stage. Lastly, I'd like to bring attention to the program she created, the NJPAC All-Female Jazz Residency. This is a picture from the 2016 program, and I was actually at this program. I'm not in this picture, but I was at this program, and it was my first jazz camp. It was my first time that I thought about myself as a jazz musician. I met a lot of my best friends there. I met people that I still play with today, and you know, safe to say at the time, I didn't realize how much of a privilege and an honor it was to be studying with Geri Allen during this summer. But now getting older and having people compare her to me and just learning more about her, I see that she's had a direct hand in a lot of things that have happened in my music career, such as coming here to Michigan State, participating in the Betty Carter Jazz Ahead Residency, working with a lot of other programs like that, inspired by a lot of her work and made possible by a lot of her work. So, in conclusion, her unique musical style and her innovations in the piano and the field of jazz education have made a lasting remark on the world of music. Her ability to fuse tradition with innovation, to push the boundaries and to inspire others, exemplifies the essence of jazz, and I'm very grateful to be connected to her. Thank you for listening. Thank you. So, in just a moment, we'll get some music started for you guys. We'll start with the small group portion, so just hold tight. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
every time that you experience things over and over again, you experience them with more understanding and deeper wisdom. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Hello. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you guys so much. I just wanted to say some quick thank yous. I have been at Michigan State for 6 years, Lord. So, you know, I've transformed as a person in my time here, and I don't want to forget anything. So let me, I just want to say thank you. I don't know who all of the professors are here, but I want to say thank you to Professor Dees, who's my first improv teacher, and really set the tone as far as excellence, playing your instrument to the highest level. Everybody who goes here knows that. I want to thank Professor Blanding, saxophone professor. Since I met him, he's been super sweet, super supportive, and you know, just always been a kind-hearted, loving person towards me, and I appreciate you, everything you've done. I want to thank Uncle G. Is Uncle G in here? Uncle G, he's like the light of the program, and you know, he makes my days better when I see him. He has more light than anybody in the program, and he's the most senior person in our program. So thank you, Uncle G. I love you. Professor Napoleon, I spent three and a half out of my 6 years here in his ensemble. And he has poured a lot into me, always been super invested, super supportive of me. So I want to thank you, Prof. Napoleon. I see Prof. Stanko in the back. Thank you for being here. Even though you just came on last year, I think you super cool guy to be around. I appreciate everything you do for the program. And you know, just seeing you around, even outside of school, I appreciate your energy. I want to thank the Whitakers. You know, they're the head of the ship, and they've looked out for me all 6 years. If I ever needed anything, they came through. Needed money for school, needed money for things, needed gigs, opportunities, they've come through. And they've been in my corner, so I want to thank you guys. Professor X, I want to thank you for everything you've done, everything you taught me. I really appreciate it. Everything, you know, from the beginning, good and bad, I appreciate it. And I want to close. I was saying thank you to these people right here. Can we give it a hand? Yeah, everybody up here right now, and you know, all my friends, I'm fellow students I see in the crowd, I really love y'all, and y'all really make my days better, you know what I'm saying? I'm having a bad day or something, I'm not feeling it. I come here, I talk to y'all, y'all lift me up. So, I love y'all. Thank y'all. Thank y'all for working on this music for me. I really appreciate it. Appreciate and love y'all, all y'all too. And last, but certainly not least, I wanna thank my family. My family came out deep today. I did not expect all of y'all to be here. So thank y'all so much for being here. I love y'all. Everything I do is because of y'all. Who I am is because of y'all, especially you, Mom and Daddy. I appreciate y'all making me the person I am. Appreciate it every day, more and more. And just thank y'all for loving me, pouring into me, always supporting me, always letting me be myself, you know, speak my mind, and just, you know, thank you guys. You know, y'all believe in me. Everybody here, y'all believe in me so much, even when I don't believe in myself, and I really appreciate that. And I'm gonna stop talking now, because I'm not about to be crying. But thank y'all so much for coming. Thank you, thank you.